Now, Sonika, let me send it over to you.
Hello, everyone. Thank you for the introduction, Robert. I am Sonika Gogginini from the Fraunhofer Institute in Berlin. We actually came up with this project OpenEffect because we were already in the field of open source projects, and we were trying to do some research and find out how we can support open source hardware projects with new research and development in this field. Of course, the COVID came, and we saw a massive rise in the COVID projects. And we thought it was a perfect time to actually go ahead and see what the communities are doing together and how effective have they been in actually solving the problem. We particularly focus on ventilators because they're not all that easy to develop. And also because they have very strict regulations with respect to medical approvals. And we thought, let's see how the open source community has handled this challenge and how effective they've been. This is where we actually came across the wonderful list done by Public Invention, the COVID Vent List, which already had almost 130 projects when we started. They also had evaluated different projects, open source hardware projects for different categories. Some of the categories like openness, buildability, and community support were some of them. So that's when we thought, let's work with them and also enhance or add a few more categories for the sake of our research. And we did that, and we analyzed these projects with data available online based on their websites or their repositories, et cetera. So this already led to a really good picture of how the effectiveness of different projects were. But we also wanted to talk to some of them. We wanted to talk to some of the projects which were on different scales in this evaluation criteria and see how did they do this? What were their best practices? What were the challenges they faced? And how could we probably help them through our research and development in the future? And this is what we've actually done in the report, which the link is also present in the slide, where we have tried to collect. We did 14 interviews with different groups, and we collect. So we have summarized all the interview results in the form of statistics, and also presented the best practices and challenges they had. So it's very interesting to see that some of the best practices were repetitive across different projects, and also some of the challenges were also repetitive. And it forms a really good base for us to say, okay, here are the few gaps that we would like to address in the future. But the best part is most of the projects have done so well, and some of them also were able to get medical approvals, which would be the most difficult actually for also companies which are doing this. So we found that it was great, and that open source hardware can actually help in times of pandemic when people come together. So, and all these results and the conclusions, and we also had a few recommendations based on the best practices where we could say that perhaps these could be used as basics or guidelines when future open source hardware projects are developed. And this can also be found in the report.
Sonika, are you at Fraunhofer?
Yes, I work at Fraunhofer, yes.
Thank you.
And so let me just reiterate, one thing that Sonika's team did is they took the COVID vent list and actually interviewed, I think it was 14 different teams.
Correct.
Which is something that I never did. Okay, so thank you very much. You guys, if you have specific questions, her report is very interesting. This is one of the first times I think open source medical devices have been seriously attempted. She'll be in the Slack channel. I don't know if she's gonna stay for the whole conference, but if you have a question, you might address it to her either in the chat or in the Slack channel. Thank you.